We have a discovery. We should state it. We have a discovery. We have observed a new particle consistent with a Higgs boson. It is a milestone. I think we can all be proud.
The Royal Swedish Academy of Sciences has decided to award the 2013 Nobel Prize in Physics to Professor François Englert and Professor Peter Higgs for the theoretical discovery of a mechanism that contributes to our understanding of the origin of mass of subatomic particles, and which recently was confirmed through the discovery of the predicted fundamental particle by the ATLAS and SEMES experiments at CERN's Large Hadron Collider.
The discovery of the Higgs boson on July 4, 2012 was a monumental achievement in particle physics, providing a clever explanation of how most constituents of matter gain mass. However, the Brout-Englert-Higgs mechanism does not predict the values of these masses and is not responsible for the masses of the lightest of all particles, neutrinos. The Higgs boson is indeed a very special particle, closely related to the structure of the vacuum of the early universe. It is so simple and yet so mysterious, and many open questions in physics today are tied to the Higgs boson. But they are by far not the only ones. Do all particles have some inner structure that we haven't yet observed? Are they additional spatial dimensions beyond the familiar three? Is the universe we live in just a special case of a vast landscape of possibilities? What is the origin of matter-antimatter asymmetry? What is dark matter made of? Is dark energy real?
This is science in progress. And to solve the mystery, we need more data.
Particle accelerators have been unveiling the structure of matter since the discovery of the atomic nucleus more than a century ago in 1911.
The general trend has been to build larger and larger particle accelerators because the scale of detail, of fine grain that you can detect, gets smaller and smaller as the energy of the accelerator gets bigger and bigger. So when you want to know more and more about what's really inside of these elementary building blocks of every substance, you are obliged to build bigger and bigger accelerators.
Accelerating particle beams is an exclusive technique to probe the structure of matter and understand the underlying laws of physics. In addition, the high energy densities achieved in particle accelerators approach those present in the primordial universe fractions of a second after the Big Bang.
The best tool that we have is particle accelerators. The unique feature of particle accelerators being able to give you all the parameters of particles that we want, it is the primary tool that we have. So is there a good reason to go to higher energy or different kind of accelerators?
New physics can be accessed by increasing beam energy and by increasing the rate of collisions to maximize the probability that the particles of the counter-rotating beams interact. Currently, CERN is upgrading its flagship accelerator, the LHC, to know more about this very special particle. With the high luminosity LHC, the potential for new discoveries will be expanded by a factor 10, allowing physicists to study known mechanisms in greater detail and observe rare new phenomena. The quest for higher energy requires larger and larger accelerators with implications for the cost, energy consumption, and complexity. Currently, R&D efforts aim to reducing size, cost, and environmental impact through innovative technologies. Larger and higher energy accelerators would be useless without bigger, faster, and more sensitive detectors to capture rare phenomena and minute details. These discovery machines pose significant challenges for operation, distributed controls, maintenance, and installation. Revolutionary computing infrastructures, powered by AI and novel technologies, will be essential for processing and analyzing the even vaster amounts of data generated by the new machines, pushing the limits of technology and innovation in many different domains. Since the creation of CERN in 1954, the unprecedented scale and technical requirements of the accelerators, detectors, and computing infrastructure needed by particle physicists has constantly pushed to the boundaries of technology, bringing innovation and sometimes disruptive technologies which have benefited society at large. The interconnected journey of knowledge and innovation will continue to unfold.
I think that the curiosity and the need to do research is inside is a part of our humanity. So there will be always a CERN.
We believe very firmly that to continue this search in the unknown, we will need a much larger accelerator at a much higher energy.
So the bread and butter is that you learn more about what you already knew, and that somehow justifies the investment. But there's always not so secret desire that you're going to find things that you didn't know. And so far it's always happened when you go to larger and larger accelerators. I think it'll happen again.